This morning, as we journey into a devotion, I learned something new. As you know, I'm in the mechanical field, but from time to time, I like to assist individuals with, you know, whatever tasks they need assistance with. So I got a little lesson in the construction area. So we went to dig a foundation for a septic tank. Now, the septic pit that those of us from the Caribbean might know, we just dig a hole and we pack stones and so forth, and we build it up, and those were the pit toilets and so forth. But now, these septics that they make, they are more high class, you know. One septic is like a small apartment with a set of small rooms in it with, you know, one area for stool, one for water, one for the water from the sink and the shower, and the one from the toilet. You know, it's all fascinated. But what I have learned in digging this septic is this. I saw that they were digging, so I thought when you just dig a hole and you do what you have to do there. So I asked the kind gentleman, Mr. Claxton, how deep does this thing have to go? And he told me that you have to dig the foundation until you reach solid. So for we in the Caribbean, we know that, you know, the hills are rocky. And in some areas, there is not much rocks. There's soil, you know. So I'm wondering, how are you going to reach solid, you know, as you dig this foundation when we are in an area that is dirt? So as we dig and dig and dig, I realized that within that dirt that we were digging, that I thought was, you know, just dirt, there is some solid dirt, you know. And when we reach to that solid point is when he said, okay, we have dug deep enough. So from this solid area, we will now set up the foundation of what we will build up to be the septic housing. So as I thought about that, and I look into our scripture for last week, which we'll also be using this week, where we speak from Jeremiah chapter 1, reading verse 17 to 19 onwards, I recognize that each and every one of us should realize when Jesus is allowing us to dig our foundation so that we can reach to that solid point on which we can build a strong house in our life. I have captioned our short discourse this morning, "The Foundation Has Been Dug." Shall we pray? Most high and loving Father, once again, O God, I come to you asking you, O Lord, to empty me of self. Father, touch me from the crown of my head, O God, to the sole of my feet. Lord, work in me and through me like never before. Father, guide my lips, my thoughts, O God, and let everything that I say, O Lord, be in accordance to your instruction. And, O Father, be with this medium that we use, O Lord, that it may stay stable. Be with all the individuals that will be listening even now. Help them, O God, to receive your word. Hide me, O God, and let them hear your voice speaking through my lips. And as we journey, O Father, all glory, honor, and praise is given unto you, I pray. Amen and amen. The foundation have been done. Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 17 onward read, "Therefore, prepare yourself and arise and speak to them all that I have commanded you. Do not be dismayed before them, before their faces, lest I dismay you before them. For behold, I have made you this day a fertile city, and an iron pillar, and a brass wall against the whole land, against the king of Judea, against the princes, against the priests, and against the people of the land. They will fight against you, but they shall not prevail against you. For I am with you, said the Lord, to deliver you." My friends, one thing that I have learned in this journey called life is that each and every one of us foundation must be built. My friends, one thing that I've learned as I journey through this Christian pathway is that some of us will have solid foundation, while some of us will have foundation just like those places where when there is a little rain, the house just moves down the hill. The sad thing is that while some of us are taking time out to make sure that we dig deep into the word and deeper into the word so that when our trials shall come, we will be found on solid ground, there are some of us that is too busy. So there are some people that when they want to build a house, they want the quickest house up. So you know you're in a location that is prone to hurricane, but still yet you just dig on top the soil and build a boathouse. And when you hear that hurricane is coming, you start to fret. While there is some people that take the time out to dig into the foundation and find that solid, solid soil and build a solid concrete house, so when the hurricane is coming, they don't have to worry. And as I use those two illustrations, my friends, there is some of us whose faith are just like those two illustrations. While things are going good and everything seems to be at its best in our life, we say we have strong faith. But when the hurricane of life shall come, we begin to worry. Some of us have high blood pressure because we have not took the time out to dig deep enough into the solid foundation, Christ Jesus himself. Some of us are stressing right now because we are not tapping into the real source of life, who is Christ immortal, Christ the risen Savior, Christ the Son of Man. But as we go through the storm in life, God have sent me by this morning to remind somebody that right now as you're digging your foundation, right now as you're listening to my voice and you're digging your foundation, ensure that as you dig deep into the word that you hide his word into your heart, because there is a storm that is coming. What storm are you talking about, Ella? Are we talking about Irma or Maria? No, I'm not talking about no storm. I am talking about the storm of your life. Each and every one of us will go through that storm. The one that will prevail will be that individual or those individuals who have dug a solid foundation and have made their stand on the solid rock, Christ Jesus, our Lord. My friends, the foundation have been dug. For some of us, we need to recognize that we are at a time when we cannot be building our foundation in sand. We cannot be building our foundation in the swamp. But we have to build our foundation on Christ, the solid rock. As I said last week, I just want to remind somebody, it doesn't matter what you're facing right now, but you can overcome it all. In church on Saturday, we were discussing indestructible faith. Indestructible hope. And when we sat there and we start to dig deeper into this indestructible hope, we recognize that some of us' hope are broken because we did not build on solid foundation. While there are some of us whose hope only gets stronger as the storm gets stronger. We were reminded of Job. And the question is asked, why is it that God allowed Job to be tested? Why is it his wife did not stand as bold as him? But exactly what you're going through right now is because God recognized that you and you can go through it. And he allow the devil. Come on, somebody. He have gave the devil authority that he can test you. He can test you, Angela. He can test you, Jerry, but he cannot take your life. So the fact that you're going through your storm this morning, somebody, is because God is saying, I know Sarah can do it. I know Angela can do it. I know Irma can do it. I know Dr. Ambrose can do it. So you can test him, but do not touch his life. So the question is, do you believe you can do it? My friends, we're going through a time. It's no more time to play Christian or to play church. We are going through a time when, you know, game time is over and the real final. It's no more semi. There is no more semi. This is the final round of it, because any moment now God is about to come. And if your foundation is not built on Christ, the solid rock, you will be lost. So right now, as we are in the final leg of life, my friends, you got to recognize when God is at work. As I told the weekend, the cry, the plea that has been, repeating over and over as I listen, I've recognized that everybody's going through something. Oh, I don't think that Ella Jerry's not going through nothing because he's preaching this morning. I am going through my storm as well. But I've ensured that my foundation is built on the solid rock. You see, despite what may come my way, I am reminded that God have made me a fertile city and of iron pillars and of brass walls. So whatever may come against me, I will have the victory, because I know that God have created a solid foundation for me. And somebody need to say that this morning. Despite what you're going through, God have made you a fertile city. God have made you iron pillars, and God have made you walls of brass. So whatever you're going through this morning, you can have the victory. It's okay to cry. Nothing is wrong with crying. But it's more important to trust God as you go through the process. You see, the one thing with the house is that once you build the foundation, you cannot lift up the house and redo the foundation anymore. The only way to do the foundation over is to demolish the building. And right now, we are not at a point where we can demolish ourselves and build it back over. Our foundation, my friends, my listening and viewing friends, our foundation have to build so strong that in the minute of an eye, when that situation come about, you can recognize that God is saying, hey, you, I want to brag on you today. Hey, you, I know that you have spent enough time in my word and you have built a solid foundation on my word. So I know you can overcome this situation. It's a weeping manger for an eye. But my friends, there is a joy, also joy, that comes in the morning. Oh, there are times that I cry because I say, God, this is so much. But every time that I cry, he always send the reminder of his word. Greater is he that is in me, that is in all the world. So if I have such a strong person in me that is greater than everything that I will come up against in all this world, why do I worry? I stopped by this morning to remind somebody that Jesus Christ has been working on your foundation. I stopped by to remind somebody that Jesus Christ has allowed you to go through this moment, because he knows that the testimony that you will share when you have overcome will be a testimony that will turn somebody's life around. I've stopped by to tell somebody this morning that the Christian journey is not easy. Oh, there will be stress. Oh, there will be problems. Oh, there will be so much that you'll have to go through. But it will be the best decision that you'll ever make in your life when you choose to follow Christ. So this morning we are reminded, has our foundation have been laid? Have the confidence to step out each day by faith, knowing that you serve an all-powerful God. Despite your present situation right now, my friends, it is not your final destination. And I'm here to tell you this morning to stand firm as you go through your storm. Stand firm as you go through your test. Stand firm just like your foundation, so that God will be glorified. Oh, there is somebody right now that need to recognize that God is speaking to them. There is somebody right now that need to recognize that God is saying, I need you to stand firm. I need you, Angela. I need you, Dr. Ambrose. I need you, Sarah. I need you, Sam. I need you to stand firm. Because any moment now, the eastern skies will be bust open, and each and every one of us will have to face the judgment. Oh, there is some of us that is already planning our excuses to tell God, but God is not coming back for excuses. He is coming back for results. My friends, we are at a point in our life where we need to recognize that there is no more time for excuses, but it is time for us to give the results that God have been telling us that he need for years. So as he have sent me by this morning to remind you that the foundation have been laid, and the question as I close is, have you built on the solid foundation of Christ Emmanuel? If you are one of those persons that said that I've built my foundation on Christ's solid rock, I invite you to raise your hand virtually or physically as I pray. Most high and loving Father, indeed, O God, we are so grateful for your presence even now. Father, even now, O God, as you reminded us, O God, that you have built a solid foundation in each and every one of us. And as we go through the storm in life, O God, you are reminding us that we can overcome. There is nothing that we are going through right now that is too big for you. There is nothing that we are going through right now that is impossible for you. But we need to turn it all over into your hands. Father, we recognize that we cannot do it by ourselves. We also recognize that greater that is in us than in all this world. So there is somebody bigger in us than all our situation. There is somebody praying for us even now. There is somebody interceding on our behalf even now. So as we go through a storm in our life, help us, oh God, to be faithful. But as the victory comes, all glory, honor, and praise is given unto you. Father, be with us as we continue the journey, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen.